Sickness is a part of everyday life. Sneezing, coughing, getting fevers and chills, and upset stomachs are things that everyone will experience eventually. Most illnesses are caused by two types of microbes: viruses and bacteria. Both are so small they can only be seen under a microscope. And viruses are so tiny, so much smaller than bacteria, that it takes a very special kind of microscope, called an electron microscope, to see them. You would think that anything so very, very tiny would not bother us very much. But microbes can have a huge impact on our bodies. Let me explain how. All viruses need a host, such as a human body, an animal, or a plant, in order to grow and reproduce. They invade the cells of the host and quickly begin to replicate. As they make more and more copies of themselves, the viruses infect more and more host cells. Some viruses replicate so much that they get into the bloodstream. This is called viremia, and once the virus is in the blood, it causes a systemic infection that affects cells throughout the host, creating a serious illness. Thankfully, not all viral infections get into the bloodstream. There are many viral diseases, however. Some, like chickenpox or Epstein-Barr, cause viremia. Others, such as the common cold, only infect specific tissues, usually in the respiratory tract. Since viruses can survive on many types of surfaces, it's important to wash your hands before eating anything, to dust and vacuum often, and to keep surfaces like doorknobs and light switches clean. What is the first line of defense your body has against a virus? It's your skin. Skin prevents most viruses from entering your body. Unfortunately, wet, moist places like your mouth, nose, and eyes are easy entry points for many viruses, especially those that are airborne and those that you get from dirty surfaces. Thankfully, our bodies have special defense systems ready and waiting at these entry points. Your nose contains tiny hairs and mucus that trap germs, preventing viruses from going deeper into your body. And then there are the acids in your stomach, which can destroy some viruses that enter through your mouth. Specialized antiviral medications might work against some viruses, but it is ultimately your body's own immune system that will defeat the virus. And here's a bit of good news. Once you have caught a virus and defeated it, your body then knows how to successfully fight off that same virus again in the future. You can help your body fight off illnesses too, by getting plenty of rest, sunshine, and fresh air, and by drinking lots of fluids and eating nutritious foods. Now that we've discussed viruses, let's talk about bacteria. Unlike a virus, which needs a host organism, bacteria are single-celled organisms that produce their own energy and reproduce all on their own. Only a very small number of bacteria are harmful. A great many more types of bacteria actually help both your body and the world. Some types of bacteria help to break down compost for a garden. Others help your body to digest food. And still others assist in the fermentation processes used for making delicious foods, such as aged cheese, yogurt, sauerkraut, and kimchi. Only a few specific bacteria are considered harmful germs. And even though some can be dangerous enough to cause death, like pneumonia or salmonella food poisoning, most of the illnesses caused by bacteria affect only one part of the body, rather than the whole body. Another important difference between bacteria and viruses is that antibiotics can kill bacteria, but not viruses. An antibiotic will not help the body recover if a virus is present. Consider the common childhood problem of having an ear infection. The infection and the earache that follows are caused by bacteria that remain located in the ear. A doctor can prescribe an antibiotic, which kills the bacteria and helps the pain to disappear. However, it's not always that simple. There are two types of bacteria based on the composition of their cell walls: gram-positive or gram-negative. Gram-negative bacteria have an extra outer membrane, which makes regular antibiotics less effective against them. These gram-negative bacteria have led the way to antibiotic resistance, which means they've developed a strong defense against antibiotics. Antibiotic resistance is one reason why it's so important not to overuse antibiotics. Careful and appropriate prescription use of antibiotics can help delay this resistance from happening. And just as with a viral infection, getting plenty of rest, water, sunshine, fresh air, and nourishing foods can also help your body fight off a bacterial infection. Most likely, when you are sick, you don't really care whether your symptoms are caused by a virus or a bacteria. You just want to feel better. But knowing the difference between these two illness-causing microbes can lead to better treatment and a quicker recovery time, so that you can get back to doing the things you enjoy.